Hello everybody, welcome to the next video, which will be about flood sensor. As I promised, today we will talk about more detailed information connected with the terminals that are under the case, also some installation information. What's more, we will pair the device with the gateway. So as far as the installation, I think that this is nothing really hard to explain. This is extremely easy to install. The first possibility is, of course, to put it on the floor, on the surface that's prone to flooding. On the other hand, you don't have to use this device and directly detect the flooding, but you can also use the external wire, the probe, which will detect this flooding. And thanks for that, you can put it in the wardrobe or anywhere else, despite the floor. The device may be supplied in two ways. The first one is just the battery. So you put the battery and that's it. And the other way is to use 12 to 24 volts DC supplier. So it's up to you which one you will choose. In a minute, I will describe what are the advantages of picking the 12 to 24 volts DC supplier, but that in a minute. Also, remember that you can connect here any alarm, thanks for the potential free output terminal. What's more, this device, just to a quick reminder, includes the temperature sensor. So if you would like to use it only as a temperature sensor, it's possible you can turn off this functionality to detect flooding, but you can of course use it as a flood and temperature sensor. So as I mentioned before, there are two types of the powering mode. The first one is the battery. Remember that if you supply this device using the battery, you will be informed about some critical situations like flooding immediately, but on the other hand, some parameters configuration or association settings will be informed in some period of time. Okay, so it depends on the interval time of waking up the device. So this is the, let's say, disadvantage of this solution. But of course, if in case anything happens connected with flooding, you will be immediately informed about it. What about the second mode of supply? There, because of the fact that it's a constant supply, we will be informed about detection of the flooding immediately. But on the other hand, also in case it's needed to report some parameters changing or some association settings, you will be immediately also informed about it. So that's a big plus of this solution. Here, as you can see, you can connect the supply. It's from 12 to 24 volts DC. G and D, it's a ground, so it's a negative terminal. Remember that this product is intended to be supplied by a certified power supply unit marked Class 2 or LPS, and as I said before, rated from 12 DC to 24 volts DC. Alarm NC is a potential free flood sensor terminal for wired systems. Tamp NC is a potential free tamper terminals, also for wired systems. Sense 1 and Sense 2 is a flood sensor electrodes terminals, and there you can connect this probe. Remember not to connect there the supply. And here is the TMP button, so it's used for add or remove the device. Alarm NC and Tamp NC connectors may be used as end-of-line protective loops terminals. So if you want the device to be mounted on the wall or in a distance from flooding source, sensor can be also used with extended external probe here. It's remember to use the extension probe or cables that are designed to detect water. What's more, probes ends should coat it with non-corrosive metal. So what if the client wants to connect both methods? Of course, you can put the battery inside and also use these terminals to supply it using the 12 to 24 volts DC supplier. And in that case, In case something goes wrong with the supply, you will not have the power or anything else. The battery will act as an emergency supply. Okay, so it will automatically switch to the second type of supply the device. And of course, if the power is back, it will automatically switch to 12 to 24 volts DC. So what if you would like to switch to different type of powering? In that case, unfortunately, it's recommended to remove the device from the gateway, change the method of supply, and re-add this device to the gateway. It is said that the battery, the life of the battery is about 2 years. Obviously, it depends. So remember about the things I've told you before in the previous videos, that it depends on the distance from the gateway. It depends on the parameters, wake-up time interval, and many, many things. So if you would like to make the lifetime longer, take care of the reports, time of the thresholds, and so on. What's more, remember about placing this device on non-conductive surfaces. After configuration of the device and pairing it with the gateway, try to do some tests. So put it on the surface of the water and check if it's working correctly. So you can also check after the configuration if the acoustic signal is working fine. To do that, you need to push these three legs under the case and wait for the signal. As you hear, it's working correctly. Another thing you need to remember about is the TMP button. So, as I said in the previous video connected with the flood sensor, under the case there is a TMP button, which is responsible for three things. The first one is wake up the device. So, if you click one time, you will wake up the device. If you click three times, or you will remove the device or pair the device with the gateway. It depends on the learning mode that you've entered on the gateway. So another thing is the TMP button, which is pushed when the case or the cover is closed. You can also detect the cover alarm opened. So in case somebody will open the case, the cover, you will also be informed thanks for this button. Remember about the fact that thanks for this button, you can also enter the menu. Okay, so for example, a huge advantage of this device, you can enter the Z-Wave range test. So if you would like to see if you are too far away from the gateway and the connection is not really reliable, you can push this button, wait for the violet color, and then confirm by clicking once again. And the information will be just the color, so you will have also the information if the range of the Z-Wave is correct or maybe it's too far away from the gateway. Okay, so now I would like to show you how to pair it with the gateway. As I said many times before, you need to use the TMP button. So now we will enter the learning mode on the gateway, and then we will click three times on the TMP button. Thanks for that, we will pair it with our gateway. Hello everybody once again. Thank you very much for watching the previous video. Unfortunately for me, that was the last video that I've recorded for you. I've decided to change a little bit my career path and I'm leaving FIBARO. However, it was a pleasure for me to conduct all the trainings and record all the videos. No worries. The person that will replace me is already chosen and trust me that it's a great choice. So remember to subscribe and stay up to date. Thank you very much and see you in the future.